It's Youth Month. It's time for the remnant to arise.
Come on. Yes, sir.
And I you will understand where God is going to take us to.
Yes,
sir. While I'm busy there, Cynthia, turn to the book of 1 Samuel chapter 3. You're there already. Who gave you that? Where is it? How do you know? Okay. 1 Samuel chapter 3. Okay.
1 Samuel chapter
3. No. I don't want you to read. I just ask you to go there. I'll tell you when to read. I just want to first get to something. There was a prophetic word that was released a decade ago by Prophet Ben Daniels. I went to go look it up and try to figure out. There's one thing I do. I always write down when it's a prophetic word, I always mark it. Or I write it down so that I can always go back to find out, did this word come to pass or is it still in the process? And if it's a decade ago, why is it taking so long for it to come to pass? I know Pastor Tumi will maybe know, so I might ask you what was the prophecy. I might ask some of you here what. Upstairs, I said to him, you better know what I'm going to ask. He said, no, he needs to go somewhere when I start. He's lying. It just tells you, you guys must take note when God speaks and it's a prophetic word, always make sure you write it down. Now, there's somebody that I know that's in the habit of that. It's Pastor Hubert. Pastor Hubert is one man that I can trust when it comes to that. He always take down notes. You can ask him anything. What was said on that day, he'll tell you. And Shans, yeah. Shans as well. They're very sharp when it comes to that. So, a decade ago, there was a word released over the ministry. A decade ago. So, we're talking about 10 years. 10 years ago, something was released over this church, and I thought to myself, go into it, because I had it, it was in my book and the date was next to it, and I thought, let me just get back into it before I minister. What is your expectation in this time? What are you expecting God to do in this season of your life? Everybody, if I let the mic go around, everybody will have a different answer, or everybody will have a different expectation. But what other word do you want? Must the word change for you to get there faster? I'm asking a question. I'm not saying it's wrong. Listen to what I'm saying. I'm saying, do you need another word? Or do you need a 24-hour miracle? Now, I don't know who's so sharp that can tell me exactly in 2014, Prophet Ben Daniels gave a very awesome word to this church. And Megan is saying, yes, sir. Can you please tell?
Yeah.
No, it was speed, favor, and supernatural growth was given in 2012. You weren't there. Oh, okay, sure. The guys, Pastor Errol, what's he? It was before you. Oh my God. Right. He gave a very profound word. It was almost like a decree. And I want the guys to please take note of this decree, and I want you to please, for the next few days, ponder on this decree. Ponder on. Wasn't my word. It was a word released from Prophet Ben Daniels. And this word for me really did something to me. And I want you to please, if you can't, go back on this sermon. Download that part only. Or take this thing, put it on your fridge. Put it in your bedroom. Put it somewhere. When you wake up, you must see. I know what I'm talking about, because I want to show you something, that what took you 10 years can happen instantly.
Yes, sir.
If only you take God on His promises and on His word, but in righteousness. What is your expectation? What are you expecting? I thought to myself, the first thing that I want to get to is, and I want to just get into this part of it, because vanaand gaan ons 'n ander diens hê. Ons gaan 'n wille service hê. And I know it. Almal gaan amen sê, want jy kom die kerk toe any which other way. So vir hulle wat aan diens loop. That's why I don't do body ministry in the mornings, because you come in the evening. In line, before I give you that decree of what a remnant is. A remnant is a complete survivor. A remnant is a special breed of people. A remnant is also a chosen one. A remnant is also one that has been set apart. The importance of a remnant is you survive through the worst time of your life. But you made it until here. Oh my God. So maybe 10 years ago, when this prophecy was given, you went through a struggle for 10 long years waiting for this prophecy to come to pass. Now I came to speak to that people that say, I have survived the storm of life. I have survived through the toughest time and through the toughest decade of my life. All odds was against me. All hell has broken loose. And the devil thought, I'm never going to make it. But I came to tell the enemy, I am a remnant. I'm a survivor. I've been set apart for a time such as. To speak to that person that understand how the enemy attacks you month after month and day after day. I came to speak to that person that don't even know where the next slice of bread is gonna come from. But one thing that you can do this morning is to lift up both your arms to the Lord in surrender and say, I am a remnant. I have survived. survived the storm of life. Do I have some people that's in this building that know what I'm talking about? I'm talking about when they gossip about you. I'm talking about when they write you and your children off. I'm talking about that individual that have everybody talking down about how bad you are and where you come from. But I came to tell someone, I am a survivor. Can you tell your neighbor, I made it until today, and I'm gonna make it even further. Do I have some people in the house? Do I have some remnants here? Do I have some survivors here? Do I have some people that went through some hell, that went through some battles? Do I have some people here that understand how to torture the bullets of life? Do I have some? Remnant.
I'm a remnant.
Woo! I'm a remnant. Joe, I'm a remnant.
I'm a remnant.
Ah, you're a Jesus.
I'm a remnant.
You're in this building for the first time, and somebody's gonna tell you you're a remnant. You're in the right service at the right time. You have survived the storms of life. You're gonna make it even further. The best of your life is yet to come. I don't know who I'm talking to, but tell someone, the best of my life is yet to come. Tell someone, I made it till thus far. I'm gonna make it even further. I don't know who I'm talking to. I've been in hospital. I've seen ICU for some time in this 10 years of my life, but I made it. Tell someone I made it. I don't know who I'm talking to, I made it. I know of days when the petrol light stayed on for weeks without end, but I made it. My business seems like it's gonna fail, but I made it. Do I have some people here in this building that can get beyond themselves? If you know you've been going through some struggles in life, then I don't want you to sit down. I want you to witness with someone and say, Apostle is talking about me. I've seen the enemy attack. I've seen the heartache and the pain, but that devil is a liar. I made it. I'm a remnant. I'm a survivor. I came through hell and back, but I came through. Do I have some people here?
Yes, sir. Preacher.
I made it. Neighbor, I made it.
I have an expectation
that suddenly things is about to change. I've been waiting for my breakthrough. But this morning, I'm standing on God's promise. Are you standing on the promise?
Are you unshakable?
Are you unstoppable? Listen to me. Go tell your destiny blockers and your haters and your dictators, you're a little bit too late. The prophecy is coming. Up
I'm gonna make it. It might not look like it, but I'm coming out.
Yes,
I'm gonna come out strong. I'm gonna make it. It's my season. Give me some time, just sit down. Remnant survivor.
Yes, sir.
Storm survivor. Oh, God. Haters and dictators.
Yes, sir.
I made it.
Hey, made it.
Come on now, somebody's got to. Just sit down for me. Let me get to my word. Let me give you the decree of 2014. By Prophet Ben Daniels. Reciting in the United States of America. Spoke this word. He said the following. You are forgiven. No. Listen. You are forgiven.
Come on.
I want to say that until it sinks in. Because a lot of people will point you to your past.
Hey,
oh my God.
Hey.
I am forgiven.
Yes, sir.
Is there somebody that know what I'm talking about?
Come on.
Somewhere in this prophecy you're going to find yourself. I am forgiven.
Forgiven.
You are free.
Sure.
Listen to what he says. You are forgiven.
Yes, sir.
You are free.
You are free.
You are favored.
Ah. Woo.
Ay, yara, yes.
Speak now.
Favored and flavored. Let me just add that. Jesus, I am favored. Listen carefully. You are. I love this prophecy. Because there's nothing doomed in this. You are financially empowered.
Speak now.
You are financially empowered.
Yes, sir.
Listen carefully. Your vision is fast forwarding. You are bearing fruit. Faith is bombastically at work in you. Your season of fullness is finally here. All things are yours. Oh yes,
yes sir.
It's for real. Tell your haters and your competitors,
yes, sir,
to drown themselves with jealousy. Favor will smile on you. Grace will grace your destiny.
Yes, sir.
Mercy will take you up. Your season of breaking forth on all sides have finally come. May heaven break loose over you. May the earth yield its increase unto you. May uncommon doors be open unto you. May unexplainable favor salute you. Your head shall be lifted high above your haters. You're about to embrace the miraculous. Move into your mansions. Take hold of your miracles. Take major steps into your marvelous and start driving your Mercedeses. Ah, Yere Jesus. Now that word, just sit down, that word was released a decade ago. That means it was released 10 years ago. Now, if I listen to this word, I've tried to find myself in this word.
Yes, sir.
Because I wanted to see, did this prophecy that was spoken into my atmosphere change my life? Listen carefully to me. There's many words that goes out. Then you know that this word is from God.
Hey,
if this word is to edify you and lift you up, then yes, it must be a prophetic utterance that comes from God. The minute somebody tells me I see three coffins, then I shake myself and say, that word is not for me. Go prophesy somewhere else. But the minute you elevate me and lift me up, then I know that this word is in alignment with what God is saying for my life, because it's to edify. It's to build and never to break down.
Yes, sir.
It gives direction. It points you in the right direction of your life. But the minute somebody speaks doom over you, don't accept the word. Because that word is not in alignment with what God has promised me. Listen quickly. There's too many people that's speaking over your life. Wait, I'm coming. I'm coming to something very important. Be careful who speaks into your life. Be careful who's a circle of friends that motivates you or speak over your life. Wait. You see, this week, this the Lord said, I must pray for the choir, just for the choir. This week I prayed for you. I'm going to explain to you why I say so. I'm talking about choir, band. I'm talking about that front line. And the Spirit of the Lord said, do you know why? There is too many negative words. Right in your circle, there's people that tries to get you down. I saw the faces. I saw what they're busy with. Listen to me. Not everybody is prophetic. They can be pathetic.
Come on.
And not prophetic.
Yes, sir. Speak now.
We need to be careful who speaks.
Yes, sir.
Oh, God. You see, that's why this lineup is going to be imperative to pray for. I'll explain to you why I say so. I'm going to explain to you. They're going to be the leaders that's going to lead us in worship one day in heaven. Oh, God. So the enemy needs to get rid of them very fast and very quick. You don't understand why your attack has been increasing time after time. I'll tell you why. It's not because you are cute, and it's not because you have long hair. Listen nicely to me. It's not because you have a good body. It's because the devil hates the lineup. It right way before this service, but I came to tell you, you're a little bit too late, because God is gonna do something brand new in your own life. It seems like you are battling and struggling, and you can't get to where God wants you to be. It's not because you are smart. It's not because you change the color of your hair. It's not because you lately have decided to wear different types of clothing. It's because the enemy knew where you're heading to. So when you are heading upward, he needs to stop you. But I came to speak to a remnant that will not take no for an answer. Because I know what my expectation is in God. I'm expecting God to do some crazy things in this season. And this is my season to recheck and revisit the prophecy that was spoken a decade ago. I came to tell you, you're in the right atmosphere. You are on breakthrough ground. Something good is coming to you. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, neighbor. And might have walked in here downcast, but neighbor, I'm not leaving the same way that I came in. I feel the atmosphere is about to shift. It's gonna come to pass. Are you ready for a move? Are you ready for your miracle? Are you ready for your breakthrough? Come on, remnant. I'm speaking to you. Lift up your eyes unto the hill where cometh thy help. Thy help cometh from the Lord, the creator of the heavens and the earth. I shall dash my foot against a stone. I will not stumble and fall. Why? I know who holds my hand. God holds your hand. Just sit down for me. In case you're gonna judge me. In case. That's a quirky. It's an Afrikaans koorkie. It's a baie ou koorkie. Okay. Ek wil net daar iets toe kom. Ek praat nie van die krag van ligte nie. Praat nie van die krag. Ek praat van die krag van die Heilige Gees. Wag. Wag eens een oomblik. Is die normale krag nie. Toe ek een dronkaap was. As ek in die krag geloop het. Bly my leven nie dieselfde nie. Ah, ek wil met iemand praat. Toe ek hoog op drugs was. Niemand kon my help nie. Niemand kon my red nie. Maar toe die krag van die Here op my neerdaal. Dat's iets van sy krag. Sy krag omskep. Luister. I can take any power to get a drug addict sober.
Yes, sir.
It won't help.
Come on.
There's only one power. It's the power of a living God that can change a drug addict and make him sober again. Julle voel, julle wil jy kom van hand kerro, jy sal jy sit. I'm busy with expectation. I'm busy building on the youth conference.
Yes, sir.
The remnant is coming up again.
Yes, sir.
They're gonna be strong again. Revival is on its way, yes. My God. Revival is not coming, revival is here. It's here. Let me quickly help you. 1 Samuel chapter 3. Quickly. I'm going to break you up somewhere. Sorry, guys. I gave you, I don't know how many scriptures. But you're going to have to forgive me. Let's go. Start with 1 Samuel.
The boy Samuel was serving.
The who?
The boy Samuel.
It's a boy.
Yes, sir.
So he must be a youth.
Yes.
Okay, the boy Samuel, what did he do?
Was serving God under Eli's direction.
Wait, he was doing what?
Serving God under Eli's direction.
Under Eli's direction.
Yes, sir.
Okay, are we there?
Yes.
And then what happened?
This was at a time when the revelation...
This was at a time. Kevin, catch me. It was at the time, youth, you've got to hear me. Listen to your apostle now. It was at the time when revelation was very revelation in your eyes is something that is very whew. As jy die ou vra, my bro, hoe was hy service? Tjo. My bro, power. Shoo. Jy moes hy revelation gehoor. Hoor so, jy sê diep nie. Revelation is only simple. It's a revealing word.
Come on.
It's when God reveals the power of the word that you are speaking about.
Yes, sir.
Oh God. Jy het nou gesing. En toe die krag op my neerdaal. En toe die krag op my neerdaal.
De baas was die daar van Pinkster, toe die kraag op my neerdaal. Weet jy wat sing jy? Dit was soos op die dag van Pinkster. Dit was soos op die dag van Pinkster. Dit was soos die dag, toe hulle daar in die upper room gegaan het. En die vier van die Here het geval. Dit was soos hy dag. Ek verstaan nie wat nou aangaan nie. Luister, dit was nie onder 'n titel. Het nog nie in sy kerk, hy is 'n apostel. Heere God, hoor hierso, jong mense, skrik wakker. Dis gemors wat aangaan. As 'n gedaante van God saligheid, met geen krag nie. Ek roep die jeug van EOMM, ons nodig die krag van God om neer te daal. Jy hoef nie te preek nie. Die Heilige Gees moet net inloop, hy moet net inloop. Yes, inloop. Jy hoef nie woord te sê nie. Jy kan net sê amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Ek voel om amen. Ek voel om amen.
Amen.
Voor jy dit weet, gaan loop die krag in. Teenwoordigheid.
Come on.
Hy nodig nie op woord. Gaan vra. Yo, Riyad. So good seeing you and your wife. Absolutely good. Listen clearly to me. Listen. Listen nicely to me. This word is very needed. We don't know. We don't want all this nice stuff. Ek soek 'n robbe kerk. Met 'n robbe experience. As jy die stilte kerk like, gaan na die stilte kerk toe.
Come on. Yes, sir.
Come on.
Maar daar wat as 'n maternity ward is, daar huil babies. Daar's Dr. Hokai. Sy sal jou die waarheid sê.
Come on.
Dis a maternity ward. Babies word gebore elke Sondag.
Come on.
As wanneer die krag op die mense neerdag.
Yes, sir.
Heere God, ek is dronk. Shucks. Ek is laat bang om rond te loop hoe ek nou dronk is. En toe denk jylle, Heere, wat gaan nou met hom aan? Nee, ek het nie een nip gehad. Ek is op... O, Heere, Jesus, toe hulle by mekaar kom, toe sê hulle, wat gaan nou aan met hulle? Is aan die tyd van die ochend, toe sê hulle klaar geswaai. Ek soek een geswaaide kerk, wat dronk is met die Heilige Gees, en met die krag van die Heere, ek soek die kerk.
Yes, sir. Come on.
Just sit down. Let it wrap up. Ever come na die ding toe? What is your expectation? I want to come to something here. Waar toe gaan jy nou? Hallo?
die skrif.
Dieselfde skrif. Ja, kom terug. This was at the time when the revelation of God was rarely heard or seen. Okay. Ons is moeg om te hoor. Die generation is moeg om te hoor van Smith Wigglesworth. En A.A. Allen.
Yes, sir.
Die generation is moeg om te hoor wat het oom Steve gedoen. Dat stil staan in die lig. Die generation sê, julle praat net klom nonsens. Hulle wil sien met hulle eie oë dat die heerlikheid van die Here het nooit gechange nie.
Come on.
Ek is moeg om te hoor. En toe se man moes daar in hy diens. Wanneer het dit gebeur? Nee, so 20 years ago. En toe een man een jong leidtie was, man het ons een ander experience gehad. Krak van die Heere, kom ons aan en hier, aan bonkies het en toe is devil en daar so. Ek was aangevul met die Heilige Geest. Heere God, ek weet nie eens hoeveel jare terug is hy. My vrou sal weet. Kijk eens wat, hy is baie jare. Daar in hy tent van bonkie, hier by devil en daar sê hy ze, dat was niks, dat was dol leeg. Dat was nie een freedom park nie. Daar in hy tent word hy gevul met die Heilige Gees, met die spreking van vreemde tale. Het was gedoop en gevul met die krag van die Here. Hulle het my uitgedra, hulle het in my kar gesit. Ek het nog gepraat in tale tot die volgende dag. As hulle met my Afrikaans praat, dan praat ek met hulle in tale. Kalebeshot, kalamashikatsandulobusa. Za wat ek gehoor het. Die plek was op die dak van hy gebouw. Daar het my pa gaan bid. En hy het my pa gebid en met die Here gepraat. En sy baas gesê, die mannetjie elke dag op 'n sekere tyd en haar koop hier op. Wat gaan doen hy daar op die dak? Julle moet die man dophou. En hulle sê, nee, die man gaan bid. Hy sê, nee, ek wil self sien. En hy gaan om my pa af te luister. Wat bid my pa? En my pa bid daar. En toe my pa klaar gebid is, toe roep hy my pa na die kantoor toe, want hy is die dikkop. En hy sê vir my pa, I did not do it, Steve. I didn't do that. En my pa vra, what are you talking about? Hy sê, you spoke in my language. I heard you speak in my language. I didn't do it, Steve. I promise you. God knows. I don't know what did you say there, but I'm telling you now, I didn't do what you were talking about on that roof. And my pa sê vir my, I don't know what you're talking about. I went to go speak to God. He said, well, tell your God I didn't do it. Can I help you here today? Then my father knew he was speaking in tongues and he was filled with the Holy Spirit. Listen to me. My father is dead. I don't know how many years ago, but I am asking, did God change? Did the prophetic change? Did the word change? I came to tell someone it never ever changed. It's still the same what my father has experienced. I can also experience likewise. Come on.
voel die Here se krag op my. Oh, ek voel die Here se krag op my. Ek voel die Here se krag op my. Hoe kan mense met kanker inloop en met kanker uitloop? Hoe kan die dowes inloop en met doofheid uitloop? Hoe kan die blindes inloop en met blindheid uitloop? Ek het gekom om te sê, is tyd vir die Here se krag om geopenbaar te word. Is hoogtyd dat ons 'n experience met God het. En is ook kyk Elias. Wat my dis sê, wat het jou pa experience? En wat weet wat het jy experience? Hold on. Hold on. Kim, 2011, you had an encounter with God. I'm going to remind you. It's before we started the church. It was on a camp. The lawn ran out. I'll give you the name. It was at Ifata. We were about 20, 25 of us. I went to go pray. I wasn't there when that glory came down. I came in late, Charles. It was 2011. I just want to show you where God took me to. There, the glory of God started falling on 25 people at once. at once. Sister Cheryl, listen to me, at once. Emmanuel, you know its face. Mag it dear oop for me. For you its face. For you net its face. Catch me, catch me. Catch me, I'm coming. Keep that door open. I'm coming to show you something. You see, when God's presence comes in, you don't know where it comes in. Are you with me? Why is everybody looking so lost? I'm gonna help you. I'm gonna help you. What you are going through now is nothing compared with what God is about to do. I know it's tough. I know you're hurting, and I know your pain. But listen, there's certain things in life God sets you free from because he's got something bigger in store. Sometimes it's hard because we don't want to hear that. I want to show you something. God, something's coming, something's coming. If I'm you, because I prepare for Fernando. Oh, Jesus. Megan, I is moeg van entertainment. Hoor my. Simon, I is moeg van entertainment. I is moeg om hoendervlees te kry. Voel lekker, nie? Die Here was in die kerk, is het? As jy hier uitgaan en jy gaan uit by die hek en niks het verander, was jy nie in sy teenwoordigheid. Jy was maar net in die kerk. Maar jy was nie in sy teenwoordigheid. Want niks wat in sy teenwoordigheid kom, bly dieselfde nie. O, Here, hy is 'n krag so. Met bevrijding, met verlossing. Sy teenwoordigheid. Apostel Eden se teenwoordigheid gaan niks aan jou kan doen. Hy is maar net 'n prediker. Maar sonder God is hy niks nie. Wil julle sê, die is Eden. Eden kan besluit om julle net hier te los en sê klaar gebreek. Hy is Eden. Eden het die gebou verlaat. Hy gaan nie gemis word nie. Hy is maar net Eden. Hy is maar net 'n stem Maar God is iets anders. God is iets anders. Ek weet jy verwag vir Eden om terug te kom. Maar Eden kan inkom waar hy voel, maar God werk anders. Jy sien ek het daar uitgegaan, maar kom by 'n ander plek in. God loop in teenwoordighede. Jy voel beter vandag. Vir jou gebid gestaan. Die mens het 'n plek waar jy hom kan plaas, maar nie God nie. God kom in. Alles is nie welkom nie. Hy kan nog inloop. En ek kan jou hele lewe omskep. Ek weet jou, kom praat ek met jou. Hy ontskep dit. Al hoe druk die lewe, hy ontskep dit. Hy werk dit in jou vywe. En al het jy gevoel, jy wil hier wees, as God. Hy wil gee dat jy moet wees. Want hy wil jou remind van jou lewe in die past 10 years. Die ups, die downs, die lows, die blows. En die Here sê, vandag is dit my kans. Ek gaan my profesie laat waarkom. Ek kan jou optel in 'n oomblik se tyd. Hier is 'n krag. Sy teenwoordigheid. Loop in wanneer jy hom nie verwag nie. Ek wil klaarmaak. Ek wil afsluit. Ek wil afsluit op 'n hoë noot. Die Here het jou gemerk. Jou lewe is gemerk. Is gemerk vir sukses. Hier wil jou ontskep. Jou lewe optel. Jou lot verander. Hier is 'n krag is in die plek. Gee my God die tweede vers, daai vers van baie ver. Want ek wil chapter 4 toe gegaan het, maar kom ons kyk net gou die tweede vers. Ek wil net gou iets naby bring. One night Eli was sound asleep. His eyesight was very bad. He could hardly see. And then, 3. It was well before dawn. In the temple of God, where the chest of God rested. I want to come to something. Then God called out, Samuel, Samuel. I want to ask you a question. Hoeveel stemme luister jy na? Samuel, 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 Eli is sleeping, his eyelids can't handle it. You know why? Go read this. You know why? Do you know why? Are you aware why? Because Eli was too burdened. He couldn't sleep. You know why? because the word was scarce. There was no encounter. The church was asleep. They couldn't hear the voice. They only waited for Eli to come up. I need to raise up and a remnant for me. Oh God, I need some fresh oil. I need some people that have encounters with God. I need to wake them up. You know what I love? You know what I love? I want you to catch me now. Devin, you and your leaders catch Apostle, catch me. Catch me quickly. Just catch me, what I'm about to say. Listen to me, listen. Apostle's not here forever. I'm on my last stretch. I need Samuels. I need to wake them up. Whether you're a girl, whether you're a boy, I need Samuels. Pastor Hubert, I need Samuels. We ran our race. We ran it with perseverance and with faith. Wendell, we have seen God. We have seen Him. But my concern is, Samuel is then working in the temple, but he never had an encounter. Samuel, why are you serving with no encounter? I'll tell you why. Young want to work under Eli's. They don't want to be chastened. They don't want to be guided. They feel they carry their own type of anointings. That's why they can't submit. They're looking for fires. That's why they go from one prophet to another prophet to another prophet, and now they became prophets with no power. Do you know why? They don't know how. They don't know how to submit under Eli.
Come on.
They prematurely walk out under the grace, because they are seeking for strange fires. Here God, iemand moet die boodskap vang. Iemand moet die boodskap vang. Hoor hierso, ek plant nou die derde kerk in Durban. Ek het die pitches ready, ek het alles ready om julle te wys. En die Here sê, nee, Constance, my kind, jy maak niks aan hulle nie. Jy nodig my krag. Samuel, jy weet wat is my probleem? Samuel kan nie eens die stem uitmaak tussen God en klink soos God. Omdat hy geweet dat Eli dra die heerlikheid van die Here. Elke keer as Eli die mic het, dan hoor hy God in Eli. Daar toe hy sê, Samuel, toe hardloop Samuel na Eli toe. En hy sê, het jy my geroep, meester? Hoor eens op, sy position is vir my belangrik. Die skrif sê, hy val voor hom neer. Jy weet wat is my probleem? Hulle wil nie weer voor hoe buig nie. Hulle wil jou equal wees. Maar hulle het nog nooit deur pyn gegaan nie. Nooit. Hulle was nooit rejected nie. Hulle was nooit in die boot van 'n kar nie. Hulle soek jou heerlikheid. Hulle wil ook profete, hulle wil ook preek. Maar hulle kan nie jou pyn dra nie. Ken jy my getuienis? Weet jy van waaraf kom ek? Was jy al opgeskiet? Hoeveel mal het jy in die hospitaal beland? Hoeveel na by die dood? Jy kan nie my heerlikheid kry nie. Elie se heerlikheid kom nie cheap nie. Want die tweede maal, toe hoor hy weer Samuel, Samuel. Herko weer na die man van God toe. Ek like die man van hier. Hy kon hom al die eerste maal gesê het, maar hy los hom. Hier by die tweede maal, hy kom en sê, het jy my geroep? Hy sê nie, Samuel, as hy jou weer roep, jy sien wat, hy luister na die stem van iemand wat hom kan guide, hoe om nader na God toe te kom. Hubert, 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 ken jy sy stem? Die skrif sê, daar roep hy hom, want Elie sê vir hom, as hy jou weer roep, hy sê, jy spreek, Here, hoor wat sê, jou diensknegt luister. Maar ek het dan gedink, hy sê, jig. Maar die keer sê die Here, nou maak ek jou 'n knegt. Nou maak ek jou deel van die gunsgenoot. Hy sê, wat het Samuel gedoen? Samuel fine-tune homself om die verskil te hoor tussen God se stem en Elie se stem. Toe hy hom hier die derde maal roep, Samuel, Samuel. Hy word van sy pa echo. Spreek, Here, jou diensknegt luister. What is your expectation? Apostel Eden. Apostel Eden. Apostel Eden. I admire your anointing. I want it. I don't admire your cars, I don't admire where you stay, but there's one thing I do admire. I don't want to dress like you, I don't want to smell like you, but there's one thing I do admire. I admire your anointing. Something's about to happen. You're gonna feel him. Like I felt him when I was young. When I prayed there on the mountaintop of Wilgespruit. And I don't know if he's late, but Pastor Durens that time was AFM pastor. I don't know if he's still alive.
was downstairs with another pastors. I was there on top of the mountain. I prayed. I said, God, I can tell you. That's why I can't backslide, Gary. Me, I can't. Can't. I said to my son in the week, I said, boy, ever had a desire to backslide? One encounter. One. I said to him, it changed my life forever. You know why? It was on that mountain. I prayed. God, I desire you. Terrence, Pastor Lester, Althea, Charlene. I was their Sunday school teacher. They were all young. Roseanne. Sunday school was before church because we couldn't use the same building because the building was too small. It was always packed. Pray there on the mountain. I said, I desire you. Desire you. I want this anointing thing they're talking about. I desire you. Whoo! It was a wind that blew over the mountain. I don't know up till today what was in that wind. Blew over that mountain. Wendell, Here God, ek voel het nou. Ek voel het soos ek het die dag gevoel het. Ek kyk, waar kom die wind vanaf? Kleo, daar was niks wind die op die berg. Laat ons klim. Die stem wat daar bid. Die man praat met die Here. Ek weet nie wie is die nie. Maar ek wil hy persoon ontmoet. Ek wil hom handskud. Because ek hoor iets in hom gebed. Hy wind kom. Ek voel, hey. Ek moet opstaan. As ek opstaan, die wind druk my. Hy sê, jy het my gevra om my te experience. Die is jou dag. Jy gaan my experience. Hy wind blaas. Ek voel hom. Blaas. Riso, ek het moes een encounter met die Heere. Krug van die Heere het my op hy berg. Ek kan nie opstaan. Ek is alleen. As jy een gemeente nie, dat is die mense, dat is niemand wat amen sê, as niemand wat halleluja sê, is net ek en hy. Jy nodig niemand om jou te affirm. As het net tussen julle twee is, tussen jy en God is meer dan genoeg. Jy nodig niemand anders om met jou. Hier ontmoet my op die berg. Ek gaan af. Soos ek afkom, hy sê vir die pastors, nee, die mannetjie moet hande op ons lê. Hy kniel. Hulle kniel. Groot pastore kniel. Hulle sê, lê net hande op ons. Ek weet nie hoe om hande te lê nie. Hulle sê, ons weet nie wat het jy met die Here gepraat nie, maar daar is iets op jou. Al wat ek sê, dit wat ek ontvang dit, dit gee ek nou vir hulle. Dit was my laaste. Hulle daar gelê, ek het afgegaan. Hoeveel ure weet ek nie? As ek inloop by die sonnagskool,
as terrens, leste my broer, leste Constance. Jong mannetjies in die sonnaarskool. As ek inloop in die klas, weet jy wat, ek sê niks nie. Soos ek inloop, die Here vul die hele sonnaarskool met die Heilige Gees. Die kinders lê onder die stoele. Die krag van die Here vul hulle almal met die spreking van vreemde taal. Ek het niks gedoen nie. My pa loop in, my pa sê, boy, ek sê, ja, nee, ek weet nie wat het aangegaan nie. Hy sê, jy hoef my nie te sê nie, ek het het gesien op jou. Die Heer het jou aangeraak. Hoorie, ek het nooit weer omgedraai. Ek het al die seuns gevat vir Gina, vir Delon. Weet jy waarom? Ek het daar ontmoeting gehad. So dieselfde God wacht nog. Hy het nooit die vier verlaat nie. Hy het net drie uitgehaal. Net vir Cedric, Meshach en Abednego. Waar is die vierde man? Hy wacht vir jou. Om nog die rivier te kom. Want hy is met jou. Hy gaan jou nie verlaat nie. Samuel. Ja, die dienstknecht, luister. Devin, van vandag, jy hoef niks baie te doen nie. Die heerlijkheid sal op jou gesien word. Laat ek julle help. Die heerlijkheid kom altyd met eensaamheid. Niemand verstaan jou nie. Niemand wil jou chommie is nie. Want die Heere wil jou nie deel met anders nie. Hy is jaloers. Hy soek jou vir homself. Luister. Niemand verstaan. Hoekom is jy so verskillend nie? Jy is verskillend because jy soek na iets. En hulle verstaan het nie. Jy is moeg van dieselfde ding oor. Oor, repeat, present, dat is niks heerlijkheid nie, hulle verstaan jou nie, maar wat moeg om te hoor na prediker, man, ek soek iets, ek soek een kante, wens, ons soek een kante, maak, ek soek een encounter. I don't know who I'm talking to. I'm tired of the normal thing my baby listen to. Your apostle. You got to desire God, my child. Like never before. Time is short. We have so little time left. Don't let your desires be somewhere else. Hunger for God. Speaking to youngsters, listen to apostle, there's no time to desire other stuff. Hunger for God. Say, Lord, I want an encounter. I'm tired of the same thing. He said, my mother, Auntie Jenny, was with her. Verlede jaar, was ons haar begrawe. Stage 4 cancer. Ek het het geweier. Ek is aan die Jennifer, jy sal leven, jy sal nie sterven. Vir die moeder gebid. Jy is perfectly fine. Cancer is a thing of the past. Somebody must desire. Doctor, okay, what is your expectation? I'm asking you a question. Little man, my boy, God is waiting for you. You had an encounter. You know what's it?
He's still at the same place. You left the place. He's waiting. I'm done.